What's up, folks? JP here. Thought I'd post sort of a video reaction or sort of a video reply to my friend Ashton. Hey, Ash. Nice to finally meet. Nice to meet you, sort of face to face. What can I say? I found your video very, very interesting, and I wanted to sort of make kind of like a video response to it, and sort of share my same experiences in sort of like film, and kind of the stuff that I do, I guess like you, I'm not used to being in front of a camera. I'm used to being behind the camera or commentating on the camera. So talking like this, it's kind of it's a little weird for me. Thought I'd share sort of my experiences. For example, I was first introduced to sort of like storytelling because I was first introduced to storytelling when I was a kid. I wrote a short story about a sort of like a king who had too much money, and he was so greedy, and I forget how the story went, but he lost all his money. And it was interesting to me because it was the first time I had ever created anything. And I think this was like in kindergarten. I was so like blown away at like how impressed I was with my own work that I don't know, I just started writing a lot more and more, but I guess maybe, I don't know, it didn't stick to me. It definitely didn't stick to me, and that's a sad thing, is that a lot of things that I do just don't stick to me. Since I got back into writing at about, junior, senior in high school, I've written about, 10 to 20 short stories. I've actually completed about 4 screenplays, and I don't know, they're usually, the way I feel about them is that they're usually they're either the greatest thing I've ever worked on while I'm working on it, or it's the worst thing I've ever worked on once I'm done and I've reread it a number of times, and it's really upsetting. And I don't know, I'm thinking maybe whenever I can, maybe I'll show you guys some of what I've worked on. For those of you watching this video who only know me from my YouTube channel or Twitch TV, I record Let's Plays, and such as my Alien Isolation or The Evil Within Let's Plays. And the reason I play those, or Amnesia The Dark Descent, or what's the other one? Or Nightmare House. I'm just a big horror fan. I love horror. I mean, check this out. I got The Lords of Salem on Blu-ray. Arguably underrated film. I actually really like this one. I know a lot of people didn't like it, but honestly, it kind of hit me like a Rosemary's Baby. I thought it was very interesting. The Exorcist. Fantastic, but believe it or not, not my favorite Exorcist movie. I like number 3, Legion, way more than this one. But I can't deny that this one is still freaking amazing, and I love watching it every single time. I also got another classic, The Amityville Horror. This is the original. I like the remake, but I don't know. I still like this one a lot more. It gives me the chills way worse. I also got Evil Dead, the remake, also fantastic. And I even got Evil Dead 2 for a little bit of comedy. My horror movie list is pretty big, but I wish it was bigger, honestly. I love horror movies. A lot of the stuff that I write is very, very horror-based. But that's not to say that I'm I've written a lot of different types of stories. I've written horror, I've written drama, I've written romance, I've written mixes between the two. I just try to stay original to myself, just sort of like come up with my own stories. I'm trying to get into a career school, try to get into art institute, something like that. Just trying to get into the thing that I love most, because when I started getting the itch to make movies at around, early high school. Me and my friends, we started doing the typical stupid kid thing when they see things on TV, like Jackass. I started making videos like that, and oh man, some of that stuff is gold. It's some of the most proud stuff I've ever worked on, because I worked so hard on it, and that's really where my fascination with video, with film, video editing, and chroma key, you know, all of that good stuff, all that stupid film nerd stuff and whatnot. That's where I all sort of got caught up in. And but later on, I started working in, I started taking film and television classes, and I started to realize I really love that art, that making, that creating something. And then I started working on short films. So I directed about two or three short films, and then a number of them I've written, but I've never actually produced or directed them. Maybe I'll share with you guys a number of, maybe a reading or two, some of the stuff that I've worked on, or maybe even post some of the old stuff, some of the old footage I've worked on. Maybe you guys will like it. It's pretty, I don't know. It's that same sort of thing, like I said. It's the greatest thing I've ever worked on when I'm working on it. Otherwise, it's absolutely terrible. 23 years old. And I'm just working. I'm just working, no school. Although I really want to go back. Film is like my passion. And some of my first films I've ever seen are arguably the first scary movie that ever legit, like, I remember watching was the movie Scream by Wes Craven. And that whole part where Drew Barrymore is getting killed by Ghostface, it was too much for me as a kid. The first movie I ever saw for sure as a scary movie was Child's Play. I don't remember much about it, and I don't ever remember being scared by it. I just remember Chucky, to be honest. I thought it was cool, I guess. But Scream really did get to me. And afterwards, I tried watching Scream 2 because I remember still being very scared about it. And I thought it was very cool. I thought it was interesting. And I just kept watching more and more and more. But arguably the best movie I've seen, as far as inspirational movies, when it comes to feeding my intense love of horror, is Night of the Living Dead. I got a copy around here somewhere, and it's the Citizen Kane of movies for me anyway, because George Romero is my largest inspiration. I've seen Monkey Shines, I've seen The Crazies, I've seen all of the zombie movies, I've seen, what was the other one? The Dark Half. I've seen that one too. I love all, and Creepshow. God, I can't believe I forgot Creepshow. I love George Romero, and so he's my biggest inspiration when it comes to making movies. So I just want to be that guy, that director, that editor, that writer. But I want to get what he has, but I don't want to be Hollywood. I really don't. I just want to make movies. It's the most fun I've ever had. It's the greatest experience whenever I get to make it. And whenever I write stories or I collaborate or I get to complete a screenplay, it's the greatest. I love that feeling. Yeah, I guess I'm all done with this video. God, I think I've made like two or three takes of this, all using the same... all essentially telling the same stories that I just told you guys, but yeah, I don't know. I kept getting a bunch of interruptions, but if you guys are watching this video, thanks for watching, and I'm glad I got to talk to you guys about my personal inspirations. And if you like, you can even talk to me, send me a video of you guys talking about your inspirations. Ash, thanks for sharing, honestly. I'm only posting this video because, I don't know, I got a little inspired by you, and I thought maybe I would send you sort of, a video reply. And it's been a pleasure. It's really been a pleasure, Ash, speaking to you over on the reservation list, and hopefully we get to meet someday or something, or work on a movie together, because that would be awesome. Anyway, thanks again for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, all of that good stuff. And be sure to check out my Evil Within Let's Plays or the Alien Isolation Let's Plays. Also, if you're interested, I'm going to head and maybe post a link to Ashton Helton in the sort of the status thing below to let you guys know that you should check her out. Give her lots of likes, comments, subscribes, all of that good stuff. And yeah, I guess that's everything. And thanks again for watching, folks. And remember, next time, share what you got.